When do you think we will set foot on Mars? In 10 years? In 20? 30? What if I told you that it won't matter? We humans are too fragile, too delicate for this kind of trip. This is not a week-long journey like what we did 50 years ago when we went to the moon. No, this is much more difficult. Despite Elon Musk's predictions and our desires to send people to the red planet, it will be a long time until someone sees the surface of Mars with their own eyes. But not because we don't want it, or because we don't have the technology or the money. No, we won't send anyone for many years because there will be no need. We will have to send something many times better. So let's look at the next 25 years of Mars colonization, analyze all the options in detail, and finally understand how long it will take us to send humans to another planet. When talking about Mars colonization, we need to remember that we have been colonizing Mars for the past 50 years, just not with people yet. We've sent many landers and rovers to the red planet, which should not be a surprise, as we sent humans to the moon even before that, so obviously we should be close to sending people to Mars, right? Is it much more difficult? Well, a little bit harder at least. Mars is almost 1,000 times farther away than the moon, and even though the difference in energy required to go there is not that huge, there are many more things to take into account to analyze both journeys. Without taking away credit from the huge accomplishment we did by going to the moon 50 years ago, it was easy if we compare it to Mars. The trip to the moon and back is something that we were able to brute force by sending all the necessary resources at once, because for starters, it only takes 3 days to go there, so you can make the round trip in just 1 week. For a crew of 3 people like they did in the Apollo missions, that's only about 80 liters of water, 30 kilos of food, and 20 kilos of oxygen. That's almost nothing considering everything that you are sending anyway, and more if you compare it to the propellants needed to come back from the moon, which were around 6 tons for the Apollo missions. So you don't need to worry about these little things, and you don't even have to think about extracting resources from the moon, you can brute force it and send everything you need in just one trip. But that doesn't work to go to Mars. The round trip to Mars is not 1 week, but at least 2.5 years. So you need around 5 tons of supplies to maintain each person during all this time. It's true that you can recycle the water and reduce the total amount needed to around 3 tons per astronaut, but it's still a lot if you want to brute force it, and we are forgetting about the elephant in the room, the propellants. You need much more than 6 tons of propellant to come back from Mars, so who are we going to solve this issue? Who would be a realistic time frame to colonize Mars? What will happen in the next 25 years? Let's imagine now the most optimistic scenario possible, the one in which in 5 years, Starship is ready to send 100 tons to Mars, and that SpaceX is capable of launching multiple times per day. To come back from the moon we needed around 6 tons, but to come back from Mars, even considering a super efficient Starship rocket, we would need around 600 tons. By the way, if you want to know any specifics about the calculations, leave a comment and I will provide all the details. Even if Starship can get around 100 tons to the surface of Mars, we would need 6 Starships to bring only the propellant for one trip back to Earth, plus another one with the crew and the supplies, and a few more with all the necessary equipment. It's not sustainable to be sending 10 Starships to Mars to bring a crew of just 10 astronauts, though when the idea is to send hundreds or thousands of people to build a colony there. Remember that for each trip to Mars, you need around 10 launches to low Earth orbit to refuel Starship, so if we wanted to send 10 people to Mars by brute force, we would need 100 launches to low Earth orbit just for one to come back, and all of this considering that everything works perfectly. Even if the most optimistic goals are met and SpaceX is launching multiple Starships per day, 100 launches for just 10 people won't be sustainable in any way. So if that does not work, what are the alternatives? Is it possible to send people to the red planet? Or is this something used by Musk and NASA to get funding? There is one way, which is probably the only sustainable way to do this without having to invent new physics or science fiction rockets. The idea is to use the resources of Mars to refuel the ships to get back to Earth. So let's see how much it would cost to produce these propellants. We've seen before that we need 600 tons, but which propellant exactly? Well, the good news is that SpaceX already thought about this when they designed Starship, so it's filled with methane and oxygen, both of which can be obtained on Mars. We would only need to land next to some water reserves and use the 95% CO2 atmosphere plus some energy to produce methane and oxygen. In total, we would want to produce around 500 tons of oxygen and 150 tons of methane, which could be obtained from electrolysis from water and then using the Sabatier process. The bad news is that this requires a lot of energy, 4 gigawatt hours of energy to be precise. But how much is 4 gigawatt hours? We need to consider that this is the total energy that we would need to produce over the 18 months of the stay on Mars, and the only way to generate that amount of energy is with solar panels, so how many would we need? Considering that the solar incidence on Mars is half that on the Earth and some other inefficiencies, we will need around 10,000 square meters of solar panels. But again, is that a lot or not? How many starships would we need to send that many solar panels to Mars? Surprisingly, not that many. Even though it seems like a lot, all these solar panels could be packed into only two starships. We may need a couple more for other infrastructure and also some way to preserve the oxygen and methane while they are produced. But even being generous with the calculations, we get that for 4 or 5 starships, we could have a propellant production plant capable of generating enough methane and oxygen for a trip every 18 months. With the brute force method, we will need to send at least 6 starships only for one trip back. Instead, using the resources of Mars and deploying a huge amount of solar panels, we can have a trip back every 2 years and a huge amount of free energy remaining. That's why the brute force method does not work on Mars, because it's way more difficult to send the propellants than to send the infrastructure to generate the propellant there. And that's the main reason why we humans will not be going to Mars until all of this is already built. So if we are not going, what is going to happen in the next decades? What are we going to send? The same that we have been sending for the past 50 years, but with steroids and a different goal. We need to remember that we have been sending robots to Mars for 50 years, and in the last decade we've sent 1-ton rovers capable of analyzing the soil and the atmosphere, capable of traveling long distances, and even capable of deploying mini helicopters. And all of this with small disposable rockets that were only capable of sending 1,000 kilos to the surface of Mars. With big and reusable rockets like Starship, we will be able to send many times more, and that's how we will be able to build the resources to send humans afterwards. The next 25 years on Mars will be full of humanoid robots deploying solar panels, of big and small rovers and helicopters analyzing all the environment, with an army of machines preparing everything so that the first humans that arrive there are not met by an empty desert. There will be no need to send any human to die there. Just think about the AI and robotic advancements that we've had over the past 2 years, then try to imagine who this technology will be in 5 more years. Why we would send a human when a robot will be much more efficient and no one will cry if something bad happens? Why spend so many resources to bring a few humans back when we can spend these resources building the architecture to make the trip something mundane? No human is going to set foot on Mars before all the propellant production plants are already built and all the energy production is in place and until we already have thousands of tons of equipment on the red planet waiting for us to arrive. We won't be going there like in the Apollo missions to take a few photos and bring back a couple of rocks. We will be going there to build a colony, a city, and to make a permanent settlement capable of sustaining itself. So the next 25 years will be like watching the construction of a theme park, waiting until everything is built and we can start sending people to another planet, and maybe, if everything goes perfectly, we can take the first step on Mars by 2050. What do you think? Am I too optimistic, or is someone crazy enough to go there before it's safe to come back? Leave a comment with any thought you may have and subscribe if you want more of this. And as always, take care and learn more.